Our work in the dicastery for the laity, family, and human life deals with every aspect of the human person. We are in charge of the vast majority of the Catholic Church and of the world. We deal with people who are baptized, people who live the Catholic faith, and people who are studying, preparing themselves to live the Catholic faith. We prepare people. In other words, in the section of the laity, we deal with all aspects, from catechetical work, which we support, to the formation of the laity to live the Christian life in the many different aspects of their life in the world today, whether it be in the world of politics, in the world of medicine, in the world of education, wherever it may be. We teach and we help episcopal conferences to prepare themselves to prepare the laity to work and to be effective in their work as Christians in the world today, to be an example to the world of how to live the gospel of Jesus Christ. With respect to the laity, we deal with ecclesial movements that began over 100 years ago, but who found a new moment in the life and in the history within the church after the Second Vatican Council. We have so many movements of lay people who are dedicated to different aspects of the work of evangelization within the church. We also deal with all sectors of the world of laity. For example, we deal with the young people. We undertake to organize the World Youth Day, and we assist dioceses all over the world in organizing annual events for the youth of the world. This has perhaps been one of our most recognized aspects of the life of our work. We also deal with the elderly, in the sense that this year, for the first time, our Holy Father Pope Francis has instituted the World Day of Grandparents and the World Day of Senior Citizens, the elderly in our society. A segment of our community that has suffered greatly during these last 2 years because of the pandemic. It is a moment when we reflect on not that they have suffered, but on the great importance that they hold within the Catholic Church, and the great importance for the future of our society, because they are the ones who transmit the faith and teach young people. Many times, because of the economic situation of our world today, the grandparents are the ones who are many times the primary educators. Grandparents are the primary educators of family today. I would also like to say a word about what we do in the life of marriage and family life. We deal with all aspects of family life, especially the preparation for the living of the sacrament of marriage, which we promote through episcopal conferences and through ecclesial communities throughout the world. It is so important today that we place a lot of emphasis on the importance of family life. The family is the future of the world and the future of our society. What our world will be and what our culture will be in the future depends on married couples creating families today. That is the future. So the importance of family life is foremost in our work. the importance of human life and helping and assisting and defending the dignity of the human person is essential to our life and to our work. And that goes from everything related to human life, from conception to natural death. And everything in between deals with the sanctity and the dignity of human life. It is so important that respect for human life be promoted in all segments of our world and of our society today. So, in a nutshell, I think I have told you everything about, I'm sure there are many things I have left out also regarding the work that we do here at this Dicastery. So I do thank you all.